Hello! This is the Chief 052, or Evan, as you will be hearing me refer to in this podcast.
Oh, yep. I am Keybear, or Kino, and I'm also going by Tim.
Yes,
he's Tim. I am Micah, also known as Shannon, also known as Lil Bruno on YouTube channel.
And I am Casey, known as MCS119 Halo.
All right, and this is Game Over Pods. Look, this is a work in progress. That was not my choice. I do not know where you are viewing this, whether it be on the Gamer Jockey, the Gamer Jockey's YouTube channel, or
that out.
Yeah, no, that's no, I don't expect you to. That's why it's there. Why do you think I overreact like that? That's what it's there for. Okay. Yeah. So whether you're watching this on Gamer Jockey's or whatever the fuck his is, enjoy.
So this is our introduction podcast / Star Wars podcast.
Yeah, it's mostly okay. Spoilers.
Fair warning, right now this is going to be about
spoilers.
Seven.
Definitely going to be spoilers.
It's Star Wars Episode 7, and we're going to bitch about it. Okay, I'm going to bitch about it. I don't know what these guys have to say.
I'm going to bitch a little bit about it.
Depends on how the conversation goes. It depends on how the conversation is going to go.
He's
a weird taste one, so he's like the oddball out.
Oh, and just in case you're wondering where we are, we're at the library in a conference room.
So no one can hear us.
It's the first time I knew that they had conference rooms.
Oh, I know they had meeting rooms. I didn't realize they had conference rooms. I actually thought small cubicles.
We'll probably go back and forth between my domicile, his domicile, Micah's domicile, maybe, and this place.
Here.
Yeah. Yeah, we like this place, so it's nice. I like it. It's a bitch to park at, but whatever.
It's life, man.
Yeah, I need a smaller truck.
or just make enough money to custom your home.
Well, custom rooms, that would be like just a truck.
Right. Well, this isn't the Let's Hear Evan Bitch About Parking podcast. This is the Star Wars Episode 7 spoiler cast. Just so everyone understands, spoiler. Okay, we're good. Spoiler.
Yep.
Well,
if you don't know what spoilers are, that means we're going to reveal secrets about the movie that you might not want to hear.
Wow, we're really covering all our bases with idiots.
So, if you don't want any of these spoilers that we're about to drop, just
go
see the movie yourself.
I mean, it's been a month already, so if you haven't seen it yet, then
go the fuck away.
Yeah, you're kind of odd out there, man. Just gone.
Hey, it's
gone.
Yo, I had to see. I had to. Okay, so I'm about to do some acting. Audio listeners, fuck you. If we have audio listeners, don't know if we do. So I was in the front row, in the nice like reclining leather seats at the mall, downtown mall, and
Northtown.
I was
at AMC.
I know you guys were other bitch places. I don't care about.
No, we were in Northtown too.
We were in Northtown too.
Okay, so I care about you guys. Fuck you, Micah.
Hey, I have really nice leather recliners.
Fuck
you.
I did too. I did too.
Wait, it was weird.
So anyway, I was in the front row, the very end cap on the left.
Right.
So to see anything, I was like this with my head angled. And so this was perif. And the faces, I could see the faces. And then like up in the right hand, top right corner of the screen was all perif. So the movie was like face the movie for me. I enjoyed it. Don't get me wrong. I was willing to deal with it.
Right.
But had we bought the tickets earlier, like I told my father to, I would have been fine.
Oh.
Okay.
Anyway, that's my little allegory.
So
do we want to go in movie order, chronological movie order? Do we want to just bitch about what we don't like?
Well, I don't. Let's talk about some. I don't know if we want to do something bad first. Or, let's do something bad to go with the good.
I fucking hate Kylo Ren. No, this is my role of the podcast. I'm just here to be that guy. I hate Kylo Ren. He's a little pussy baby bitch throwing tantrum motherfucker.
So real quick.
Also, it's kind of interesting how like he wears his mask the whole time. Like, so he's like restraining himself and like, why are you wearing a mask?
I got to cover that part.
Sorry. Not horribly disfigured. You just have an afro and a very pimply face.
But so, he was the not Vader, so.
Yeah, he was trying to emulate. He was trying to emulate Vader. Yeah.
Yeah.
even had like a shrine with Vader's helmet right there.
He said, "Show me again, grandfather," which leads us to believe that he's been talking to Vader the whole time. But I've heard several fan theories that this is the one I like, where since Vader was on both sides of the Force, there's a Sith Force ghost of Vader and a light Force ghost of Vader. So it's maybe that we have two sides of Vader ghosts to Kylo Ren,
right,
or Ben Solo, whoever you want to call him, whatever you want to call him, excuse me. So we have maybe the dark side being a little bit more word.
Or
evil.
Cruel?
Duh. No, you guys. Be inside my head, please.
Yeah.
Insane.
No. Being more
schizophrenic.
I hate my brain. It's a really easy word too. I know it's a really easy word.
We're gonna come back to it.
Yeah.
Yeah. Well,
so,
influence.
Alright.
There's more influence or whatever. Yeah.
So speaking of family, you think that Rey is
Luke's daughter, yeah.
Lots of people have disproved that on the internet.
I still think it's disproved. I think she is Han's daughter. Han Leia's daughter.
Mm-hmm.
I actually like a fan theory.
And then whole split siblings thing bullshit again, because, you know.
Kind of like
not Star Wars original trilogy movie.
There's a, I like, everyone here should understand that everyone in this room is a fan of Achievement Hunter and Rooster Teeth.
Yes.
And we watched their spoiler podcast. And I like Blaine's theory where Rey is a clone of Luke.
That could be.
Because, you know, there's just Luke's hand flying around in space after it got cut off of Bespin, right?
Right.
That's Cloud City Bespin, right? Battle for Knowledge, don't fail me.
We don't know who she was waiting for either, so.
Yeah. So maybe the Empire found it and was trying to make a super sensitive Force clone like they did with, like they cut out Starkiller. So like a Starkiller-esque thing, but
right.
Rey. Well, I don't know why they would make it female.
I don't know.
Maybe they're
like,
under the...
Well, it's like X-Wing thing and X-Wing.
Maybe
they're... Hey, female, it's Wolverine because of reasons.
Maybe they're under the... maybe they have the understanding that... they have the understanding that for whatever reason, females happen to be more Force-sensitive. So they maybe made a Luke clone, but made it female to make it even more Force-sensitive for some reason as a weapon. And then the idea is that maybe Luke figured it out and like dropped her off on Jakku, and that's who she's holding hands with.
Maybe we have no idea.
No, we have no idea. That's one of the that's a fan theory from Blaine. Rooster Teeth shout out. so that was his fan theory, and I actually really like that. You know, I like the idea behind that. It does make some sense.
It does kind of make sense because there's the whole Clone Wars thing. So
Clone Wars is so shit.
But yet we're going to ignore the Clone Wars because it's now canon.
Yep.
It is canon. It's always been canon.
I like that.
They just did a series on. Finally did a series on.
Got to be like there, damn.
Because it was technically books before it was a series. And if it was still books, it probably wouldn't be canon because it's 8 years.
Sadly.
They took all the books and put them in a big Hitler pile and burn them all.
Well, the only book that's actually still standing right now is Aftermath, which is like the prelude, and that's the there's a series, but Aftermath is like the adult version of the actual series because there's like a whole bunch of kid stories talking about like Han, Leia, and Luke,
and the rogue and C-3PO. That's why he had the red arm.
Yeah,
people don't understand side stories.
So like I got,
but so I know for a fact they made references to the book, to several books and the movie.
Mm-hmm.
But
I guarantee you,
references to books that aren't in the canon anymore.
I guarantee you, it was J.J. Abrams trying to say, "Hey, I'm a fan, and I don't agree with what Disney's making me do." But you know, Disney doesn't understand the books because they're not fans; they're assholes. So I'm just gonna put some of it in here anyway.
He's the only person that has done Star Trek and Star Wars.
Yeah, that's really cool.
To the best of his ability, even though Disney was like, no, do it the way we tell you to do it instead of the way that you want to do it.
And you know, I get a lot of hate. I probably get a lot of hate for this. I like the new Star Trek movies. I thought they were fine.
I know that I think Gene Roddenberry and George Lucas were friends, so there is mm-hmm. actually a crossover between the two series.
Yes,
so people are like, yo, it's actually just like, that's fine.
You're never gonna see Captain Kirk with a lightsaber.
I mean, have you guys seen those little comedy videos where it's like Darth Vader versus the Enterprise, or it's like Captain Picard's like actually snapping at him, and they actually blew up the Death Star using the Enterprise?
I've never seen that. I'm gonna have to ask. That's a place of the internet that I didn't know existed.
It's all on YouTube. It was actually kind of funny to watch.
Okay. So back to me bitching about Kylo Ren, because there's going to be about 10 minutes of this.
Oh, yeah.
He's not scary.
No.
Whatever anyone wants to say. He wasn't through his training. So, you know, he's not supposed to be scary or awesome.
Oh.
Yeah. And I get the inner conflict thing. But the point in the story right now, the dark side inside of him is winning.
Speaking of pussy bitches, can we talk about the big giant guy who's not really a big giant guy, but just the CGI thing, all around thing?
Snoke.
Snoke, yeah.
Okay, like, yeah. By the way, it's a spoiler cast, so just say the damn name.
You can remember.
I couldn't remember it.
Oh, you couldn't remember. That was the Micah I couldn't remember face.
Yeah.
Understood. So, okay, first let me finish my bitch about Kylo Ren. So, he's not scary, for one. He looks like Hot Topic threw up on him. Now, I'm ripping that off from somewhere, but I agree with it.
It's not as speaking of
Snoke.
Speaking of, no, not as bad as the new Batman.
Oh yeah, Joker.
The new uniform in Batman vs. Superman looks like somebody's trying to cosplay as Batman at a convention.
It's
just a big, fat, bulky. Like, what is that? Like, Superman looks fine. Wonder Woman looks fine. Like, but Batman looks like.
He's just a
brute. It looks really stupid.
All right, getting off topic. Getting off track here.
Right.
Back to me bitching about Kylo Ren. Looks like Hot Topic threw up on him. That's a given.
Yeah.
We understand that. not to mention his face goes with that. Hot Topic threw up on me.
Yes.
He looks like someone who shops at Hot Topic, for fuck's sake. They couldn't have nailed that any more than they already did. Now, not scary. He's a temper tantrum throwing little baby pussy bitch bastard.
Yeah.
That's the word. You never saw Darth Vader fucking destroy shit when he was angry. The only thing he did is he force choked the person whose fault it was.
I find your lack of faith disturbing.
Yeah. No,
like,
that is what he does.
He threw like a gamer tantrum over like
he was me playing Call of Duty Black Ops 3 on realistic. That's what he was. That's what he was. He's every time I yell Chumbawamba, that's what he did. That's what I wanted to do. But by the way, I own everything in my room, so not going to happen. And I also don't own a lightsaber. But you know, so the let me clip myself.
Breathe.
I'm that guy on the podcast. This is what's gonna. That's my persona.
No, it's all good. It's all good.
Bite my finger because I'm trying to remember. Right. He's a I'm not going to go through that again. He's a temper tantrum throwing baby.
Right.
Mm-hmm. It takes some of it out of it for me.
Yeah.
Like, I don't want to see the bad guy. I'm looking at the camera for instance. I don't want to see the bad guy throw a temper tantrum every time he loses. I want to see him go, all right, well, your fault, you're dead.
The droid that we were looking for, it escaped again.
Murder thousands of dollars of computers.
With a girl.
Watch.
And then when
like, you do the attention with the girl. What girl?
Not to mention,
and then
not to mention the like millions of dollars of computers he ruined. But he hurts himself.
You know what I want to see?
Right? Like he stabs himself. He see. Isn't there a scene where he's bleeding? When he's doing that, he's
no, he punched like, himself though.
Yeah,
yeah,
so
that scene though, but
yeah,
he didn't. Actually,
I thought it was bleeding.
No, he did get cut, and to fight the pain, he just punched it. Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. So he like he hurts himself. He's like a 3-year-old at GameStop that couldn't get Call of Duty.
or like someone on Halo 3 who couldn't get their sniper rifle, so they could shoot in the head and you're on their game. But I want to see a GIF. Someone edited a video together of him throwing tantrum and then the star lamp blowing up.
guys, we're in a library. We gotta be quiet.
That'd be funny.
I love laughing, you know, but I haven't yelled as loud as I want to.
Yeah.
Yeah. You guys know how loud I get.
Yes.
We play video games. What do you think? Anyway. Yeah. So fucking hate Kylo Ren.
Right.
All he bitches who's just like, oh, he's part of his training, and he's, there was a cool word. it's like sexually confused, but forcefully confused. it was cooler than forcefully, promise.
His Metacorians are out of count.
No. I'm going to throw him out. Who wants to help me throw him out the window?
I volunteer as truth.
Oh, okay. You want to get thrown out the window in his
voice? That was episode one. That was the only episode.
I know, and that's why I just wanted to...
And they had the coolest actor ever say it!
Yeah. But it's like, oh, so that's...
Yeah.
We're never going to mention that again.
Anyway. Words, get on track. I don't know the bitch. We know that. We discussed why I think that. Now, back to the dual-sided Darth Vader Sith Ghost thing.
Okay.
I like that idea. So the idea with that is that he's back and forth like talking to both of them,
mm-hmm.
but the light side one, I'm flipping off the camera now, the light side one is not as loud a voice,
right.
as the, we'll go Anakin and Vader for now.
Yeah.
So he keeps talking to Vader, right?
Right.
And so that's what influences him to join with Snoke.
Snoke.
Fuck. Okay, now we're done. We're done with Kylo Ren. We're done with the Force Ghost conversation because I like that.
I'm done with Snoke.
What the fuck are you thinking? You are going to get a Voldemort-looking motherfucker and call him Snoke?
Do you remember this is like any Circus would play, but it's not any Circus playing, so it's like...
it's a Gollum Vader fucking Voldemort. Did I say Vader? I meant Voldemort. I'm sorry. fucking hate Snoke.
And it's just like this big giant thing. Oh, like cool. That's a cool character.
Now imagine everyone. No, that would have been nice. No, but here's more about my shitty theater experience. It wasn't that shitty.
I got to sit on leather seats, but I was in the front and had to go like this.
No, I'm not. The white people problems. We're not about the white people problems today.
Mm-hmm.
I was sitting in the theater, and then they're talking to Snoke, and he's on the big hologram thing, and I'm like, oh, well, why does he look like Voldemort? I did that in my head.
Right.
And then Kylo Ren walks up, and he's like, Lord Snoke or something. He said Snoke.
Right.
And I could not stop myself. I went out loud.
Right.
Everyone in the theater.
Yeah.
Right on me. Right, because I'm in the front. There's
right.
not one person that doesn't know who the fuck just laughed.
Yeah.
Not one. And I'm just like, I don't even care. That's the dumbest, most funniest fucking thing I've ever seen in Star Wars.
I
like,
know.
You can bitch on fucking Jar Jar Binks all you want. He's comedic relief. That's what he was there for.
Mm-hmm.
Fucking get over yourselves.
I love Jar Jar.
Yeah, okay. He's not that good. He's not that good. But I fucking why? Snoke.
I still think it would be a better character if he wasn't a hologram.
So it was like Jay, it's whoever the fuck wrote this. It was like, what does he look like? A snake. Oh, I don't want to call him Snake. Let's call him Snoke. What retard was just like, it's a snake! Someone next to him was like, no, it's not a snake, it's actually the new leader. They said, oh, he looks like a... Yeah, what should we call him? We're leaving the decision to you. You retarded motherfucker. Well, let's call him Snoke because he looks like a snake.
This is retarded monkey, man.
the same retarded monkey that writes your fortune cookie fortunes.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I will admit that before they even had him speak or even said Snoke's name, I'm going, okay, that is a very interesting character. And then it's just like, Lord Snoke. And I'm like,
yeah.
Even you know it's bad when Han Solo even has issues with his name.
Did Han Solo say something about it?
Han Solo, he like pretty much refused to call like say his name. Like he said his name like once, and then he was like Palpatine or whatever the dark side leader is or whatever. He said it like once, never said it again.
That's so stupid. Why would in the world? I don't care what extended universe shit that comes from. Fuck you for calling him Snoke.
Again, also extended universe, not canon universe.
We do have the books, though. That's the thing, though. It's like, we're going to have to go through and read all
those. Looking
at
the camera right now. This goes out to the guy who named Snoke. Excuse me. Wherever you are,
fuck you.
I mean, come on, Emperor Palpatine before that, and that's a much cooler name. Still kind of silly name, but better than
I can't not hear his name and not think of Saltines.
Hey, let's eat some Snoke. Hey guys, wanna go down to the store and buy some Snoke?
I don't want Coke. I don't know why you're calling it that.
Snoke.
I don't want Coke. I'm not a drug addict. Get out of here with your fucking drug addict.
I do think that Snoke's hologram may or may not be his actual form. I feel like he probably is like what Wizard of Oz did, which was have a man hiding behind the curtains using smoke and mirrors and sound effects to create a giant face on the wall.
My question then is, what in the fuck was he thinking that would be intimidating for?
It's not. It purely is not.
It would have been cooler if he wasn't a hologram. If that was Snoke, like, okay, that's kind of cool.
This podcast is going to be a lot of me sighing.
A lot of that's just giant things.
That looks like Voldemort got caught in a grease fire and grew to be the size of a 20-foot giant.
Yeah, but they personally had like the set ball just to reveal it's a hologram. Like, what? You could have left that out of the entire movie. And like you just assumed that it was a big giant thing.
What Palpatine did when he gave Order 66, which was just throw on a cloak and just say execute Order 66.
No, you gotta go execute
Order
66. Yeah. Stupid motherfucker.
That's pretty much what they could have done.
Even with a giant helmet.
First
of all,
and they could have called him something better.
I love what my mother does. I love my mother. Everyone knows that. She calls him Snooky.
Wait, after the girl from Jersey Shore?
I love her for that. I love her for that so much because I hate it. I hate Snoke. And I cannot stop laughing about Snooky. It makes me laugh so much. I love my shout out to my mother. Okay. Security guards looking at somebody.
You're fine. So on a bright side, actually, like for a good note.
Being too loud. We should shut up.
That's okay.
Well, we can't shut up because it's pocket.
For a dark side, we have the whole entire, you know, the two characters we don't like. So obviously, we don't like Kylo Ren and Snoke.
Yes.
For a bright side, I actually thought
we should get off the dark side for a little bit.
Well, that's what I'm saying. Let's go on the dark side. Not the light side.
Come to the dark side. We have cookies.
I actually enjoyed some of the actual effects. Like a lot of the actual space battles and stuff.
They look fine. Of course
they do look fine.
Have you seen the video game?
Yes, I've seen it.
Okay, so of course the movie's gonna look good because it's all pre-rendered.
Well, I get that, but I mean, idea behind it, like what they're doing, like the whole entire. Now the downside for this part is the planet cracker or Starkiller. But the idea of how they were fighting it.
I hate that Starkiller was like, no, he's not a badass clone anymore. He's just some
like on these actual.
Oh, not in the.
That new planet that they were.
Death Star planet.
Oh, Death Star planet.
Yeah.
I think it's called
Starkiller.
That's what I thought they called it, Starkiller. That's what I was like, what the heck?
I'm agreeing with you somewhere along. If we're wrong, you can bitch us in the comments.
It's not Death Star.
It's not the Death Star.
Death Planet. That sounds like a bad metal band name.
No, but I thought it was called Starkiller because it actually sucked up the sun and then shot it out.
Yeah,
that's
what
I thought.
But that was under the
impossible. They have to
move the. Yeah, well, that's just shitty. That's just shitty design.
Half the planet's shit.
Like a certain distance to a neighboring star to be able to.
Also,
use.
You have to.
See, that you. So, no. Hold on.
There's all sorts of.
Guys, hold on for a second. So, you built a thing that sucks up a star and then kills like four planets at once. But when you suck up the star, the planets are going to die anyway. You already invented a planet killer. You didn't need the giant laser beam.
They just wanted the extra power.
The laser
beam
is more fun.
I mean, yeah, it's going to take a while.
Actually, it was a hyperspace shot.
Okay.
It traveled through hyperspace.
Okay, I wasn't expecting.
That's how high-powered it was.
See, I wasn't listening. After Snoke, they explained that after Snoke, and after Snoke, I started checking
out.
Okay.
Like, no, seriously, I couldn't take it anymore. I just couldn't take it seriously anymore.
Wouldn't creating a hyperspace portal just for like essentially a
laser?
Bullet,
A bullet, yeah, okay.
Wouldn't that take most of the energy from the gun?
That's why they use the sun.
That's why they use the sun, yeah.
And then the regal shots are just pretty much as powerful as the Death Star.
So essentially
yeah,
what they should have done is they should have flown the Starkiller to a system they didn't like. And then sucked up their star, killed all of them, and then shot Coruscant. Which, by the way, is their biggest fuck you to the prequels. We're just going to kill your main planet. Don't worry about it.
It was not as gruesome as the book.
Wait, did they get Naboo in that blast?
I think so.
I don't remember.
I
just don't remember Coruscant dying.
I think they did.
Well, then they killed the two most bullshit planets. Tatooine's fine because it was in the originals.
They have Jakku now. Non-Tatooine.
You mean Tatooine?
Tatooine's
without two sons.
Yeah,
or was it three?
Which is weird because it made Jakku to be out. I was like, oh, this is like really important in space battles, and it's like, well, that's just Tatooine, ain't it?
No, it's Jakku.
If only Tatooine got that, because then everyone would be like,
why do all the
awesome,
force sensitive ones come from a desert?
All the scavenging.
Yeah.
Is there something about desert, the environment on a desert planet that just...
There's crunch. There's crunch.
that just, like, is the perfect environment for force-sensitive children to be born on?
Yeah.
Fuck Rodeo. Let's go to Tatooine. We
no,
don't need
no,
force-sensitive...
No,
okay,
no,
I'm talking
no,
about a...
Jakku.
I'm talking
fuck
about... I'm talking
yeah,
about a...
Not,
when I say fuck Rodeo, I'm talking... In my head, I have a Star Wars...
Did anyone think that the secret planet that she was supposed to go to was going to be...
The one with the Jedi Temple and Luke Skywalker on it?
Yeah. Did you not think that was going to be where Luke went in his small trilogy?
Dagobah?
Dagobah. Yeah,
it's another side of Dagobah that's mostly ocean?
Because it was like, I don't know, because when we first were on a solo planet. They're going to go to Dagobah, and he's like, no, we're going to go to this like, random planet. And I was like,
yeah, he never told anyone about
Dagobah.
He never told anyone about Dagobah.
Dagobah is like, is like the planet that has the largest confluence of force right there, because everything on that planet is alive.
Well, I mean, if you watch The Clone Wars, that's where Yoda went to learn how to become a force ghost. I did not know that before The Clone Wars. I didn't know that you had to, like, learn how to become a force
and
ghost.
And also taught Obi-Wan Kenobi how to speak with his dead master.
Yeah.
And apparently Anakin was there as well at some point. But we don't talk about the original
bullshit.
He somehow learns to become a Jedi.
I am part of the generation that hasn't seen the original version of Star Wars. I've only seen the edited versions. With all this stupid, like... What are the dumb things that the stormtroopers ride?
I don't know. There's like two of them. They're like...
Dewbacks.
Dewbacks.
With all the stupid dewbacks, and then the CG rocks hiding R2. And there was a wolfman in the cantina. I never got to see the wolfman. It's just some dude smoke. I looked up a video to see all the differences.
Right.
And, you know, I'm part of that generation. I don't know if you are or aren't.
There's actually three different versions of the original series.
Yeah, there's the 2000-something one. There's the 2011 one.
Mm-hmm.
And then there's...
A special edition, which had some... A little bit of some of the scenes were actually added in as well. Some were edited up. So yeah, some of the scenes.
No, but it's really funny.
Blu-ray.
So I had a math teacher. I think you may have also had this math teacher, Mr. Burns.
Mm.
No, okay. So I had a math teacher in high school, and he loved Star Wars, and he would tell stories about how he and his father just on the weekends, he his father and his brother on the weekends, his father would go, yeah, you guys want to go see Star Wars? And they're like, yeah, because it was all cheap back then, and that's what they just would do on every weekend when it was out. And he and I got into an argument after school one day when I was there for help and I was done. About Han Solo and Greedo.
Yeah.
So who shot first? But I'm part of the generation that's never seen the originals, right? So I'm used to the stupid CGI Han Solo dodging and then shooting thing.
Yeah.
But I was sitting there arguing with him for like 20 minutes. I'm like, I pulled up a clip on YouTube and he's like, oh, that's what you're talking about? That's the edited version. That didn't really happen. I'm like, well, for me, that's the movie.
Yeah.
For our version,
that's the movie, and like.
And the original version was just like word for change, and then like shots were fired, and Greedo was dead, and like, the fuck does that?
In the newest of the Blu-ray version, what they did is they took that whole Han Solo like
just
force neck dodges.
Yeah.
They took it and like sped it up, so now it's the same length as the original scene where he just fires and there's smoke everywhere. So it's kind of hard to tell, but obviously you can if you've seen it before. And I don't know what got me on this tangent, but like that's just what I was just thinking about that. Like, I have not seen the original movie.
So who did he say fired the first shot?
He said Han did. I said Greedo did, because again, in the digital version, he did. And you know, we had that argument for like 20 minutes, and like.
Well, and then you also have to take into consideration in the new Battlefront that Han Solo's special skill is quick draw.
Yeah.
So Battlefront is actually going to be the first game that's actually going to be a tie-in with the actual new movie, because they actually do have Battle Gaku.
Gaku?
Jakku. I call it gods. You know.
No.
Anyway.
The J and
the G.
Sorry.
We've gotten really far off topic from Star Wars.
That's what I'm going back into it, so.
And I would also tip Haku, but.
Okay, so Battlefront's. Yeah.
The call video. Oh, no. I don't know what that is.
The Spanish
J. Oh. Oh,
yeah.
Fuck you.
So,
I took Spanish. Fuck you.
When I was actually playing Jakku and actually seeing the actual field, like that whole entire battle, they kept talking about, like, oh, this is the area where this great battle happened, but you don't see it. And so you actually go sit there and actually go play and load up, even just the beginning of battle, Jakku. Is actually pretty intense. You're standing there, and all of a sudden there's
it's a wrecked Star Destroyer, right?
Not just that. They also had an orbital strike at the very beginning.
I don't remember that.
Like, when I first started up and I loaded up everything, I'm like, oh, cool, this looks beautiful, because it's my first time seeing it.
It's dice.
Next, well,
of course, it's
obviously
going to
be
awesome.
Beautiful, but I was like, this looks pretty awesome. Next thing you know, orbital strikes all over
for
the ground.
Everyone?
Stop.
You guys keep talking.
I want to say that as a person who's never played first two Battlefronts, I thought three was fine.
Oh, really?
I haven't played one or two. I've watched people play one and two.
You guys can't see it, but I'm flipping you off.
Yeah. I've watched people play one and two, and the only one I played was three, and I thought three was fine. So I don't come from the mindset of having played them. So I say fuck all the people who say Battlefront, the new Battlefront's shit, because it's fine. I like it.
Let me like it.
One and two are better.
You see,
I will give you that. I'm sure they're better, but I thought it was fun.
Changing batteries on the camera.
That's all right.
I'll get some dead screen time.
No, I just put some accents.
My screen's still going, so.
I'll play
some audio.
Well, I know we have audio, obviously. Yeah.
And so, no one will hear any of this. I'll probably put this out too.
Oh, you're talking about that? Well, yeah, all I'll do is I'll just go and play some games or do some footage and throw it in there. You know, show them what's up.
I'll do a montage of all my fails from Witcher 3.
And
just pause.
But,
we're on video games now. More Star Wars, please.
Yeah, well, I can go back to Star Wars off. Back to actually episode 7. One of the things I did have a problem with, I love the character. From what I'm understanding, everybody loves him. Poe Dameron. I mean, just Poe. He has a last name, I don't remember what it's called though.
Poe something new around new shit.
But
yeah.
Everybody
okay.
I talk to.
Shut up. 3, 2. Okay.
Everybody I talk to actually loves that character. Like this Poe guy.
Poe's not bad, but he's there. He's got like 30 minutes of screen time.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. The thing I didn't
I was assuming, going into it, I have to adjust my pants. going into it, I thought Finn wasn't going to be that major of a character because Poe was in the beginning, and you've only seen Finn in a couple of scenes. Now, if you avoid all spoilers like I do, I watched the first two trailers where they didn't really spoil much, and that's all I saw. So I assumed Finn would be like kind of a side story sort of thing.
Yeah,
I didn't really spoil anything in trailers. It was actually pretty good, not spoiling.
Oh, okay. Well, I heard some people say that there was, so I didn't even want to try at all.
It's stuff that doesn't make sense unless you watch the movie. That's what we're getting at.
Okay.
Yeah.
So, words. Yeah, I thought Poe would be more, because I watched it, and he was the first guy on screen.
Yeah.
I thought he'd be more of an integral character, but he wasn't.
Except for if you see like the banners, he's the one holding the lightsaber, which doesn't make any sense to watch
the movie. I never saw the banners either.
And then
I had no idea that Finn used the lightsaber at all until I saw the movie.
Mm.
That's how good I was.
But even at that, they're using Skywalker's original lightsaber, which was the hand-me-down from his father.
You mean the one that killed all those younglings?
Yes. Yes, the ones that killed all the younglings.
I wouldn't want to touch it.
Well, no, there's just too much bad blood behind it, but then it's just like, how do you get your hands on it when it was supposedly...
Did you touch it, you saw it, you freak out.
Yeah. Well, it fell off. I assume someone found it. There might be a side story movie.
Whose
name I forget.
I thought only Jedi ever... So I thought...
The one that had the lightsaber. That
Rey?
No, the one with the glasses.
Han Solo and I almost called him Chucky. Chewie went to go see at the cantina, the new cantina scene, Cantina 2.0.
In the universe, isn't Star Wars universe, aren't Jedi's only supposed to be the open up the lightsaber or start the lightsaber?
No, I hadn't heard that.
I hadn't heard that.
No. In fact, in Clone Wars, the Mandalore, the new leader of Mandalore, he had a Old Republic black starry lightsaber, and he used that.
Yeah,
but. That's right. It's Jedi can only instruct them. That's right.
Construct, yes, because they have to use the Force to construct it.
Yes.
They have to go to. They have to go to this planet with a bunch of
gems. All about lightsabers by playing Korra, which is no longer canon. But.
That's stupid.
But there might be.
I mean, no, but
Korra here soon.
I'll tell you right now. I'd pay money. In the Clone Wars, close to KOTOR, the Clone Wars got the. The idea of making your own lightsaber correctly.
Yeah.
There was an episode where Ahsoka, who's still Padawan, by the way, so I don't know why the fuck she's doing this. She took younglings to get their crystals for the first time.
Right.
And she kind of like, she Yoda'd them. She threw them in the cave and then left.
That's what every Jedi Master does to their Padawan. They're just like, hey, we're going to go to this desolate planet. And I'm going to throw you in a cave. Good luck.
It's what Obi-Wan did to Anakin episode 2. Like, here, you're on the planet. I'm going to go off you this thing. Bye.
Yeah.
whenever you manage to, if you survive and manage to make it work.
So, they did that pretty faithfully. The way that they had to go through, force drug hallucinations. Where they had to like battle their innermost demons to figure out which lightsaber crystal was theirs.
Right.
Because there's just a shit ton all over the place. They have to figure out which one is theirs.
Which is kind of weird in KOTOR, because KOTOR 3 years, like, well, this is how you build your lightsaber, and now you can just pick the different. They have no purpose whatsoever.
Yeah.
Just like whatever color you want.
Like in the Force Unleashed. Yeah.
Which sadly doesn't count anymore.
I know, but I loved it so much. It was a good game.
Yeah, it's the original Starkiller.
Speaking of KOTOR, so Bioware's task, because EA went and bought the license for like 7 games, I think.
Star Wars 13-13?
They bought the rights for 17, probably, I think,
and
7 games. And 7 Star Wars games. And they hired.
Which I would play.
Actually, it was in the original mix for a summer game. They fought for the right.
Yeah, I know. And then EA was like, okay, well, you fought for this. Guess what? We're going to whip you into shape. You better fucking get that shit out. You're a game-producing whore.
Despite the fact that they also tasked Visceral and BioWare with making one. And
Visceral's busy with Dead Space 4. Shut your mouth. I want it.
But Visceral's also, they're probably the
They took that year off to fucking make Hardline, which was a piece of shit.
Visceral's going to make 13-13 remake.
Yeah, this
was BioWare has said nothing about their Star Wars game.
No, they've kept like a tight lip and instead of that, here's the information about the new Mass Effect and
Andromeda. Everyone's like,
but you made
KOTOR. So, and now that the KOTOR games are non canon, you can go back and make KOTOR 1 again and completely redo it. So that is canon.
And it looks amazing.
And it would be
And people like me who've never played, and people me. People like me have never played KOTOR, but heard shit tons about it. That's how I know.
It's awesome.
Yeah, I know it's awesome, but it doesn't age well.
Right.
And I really don't want to go back and I suck with keyboard and mouse. I really don't want to go back and like.
Do you not have an Xbox?
No. What the fuck? Fuck you.
No, I'm talking about the original Xbox.
No.
I'm playing.
The guy had a PS2.
I've been playing with the controller.
Oh, you can do it on the PC like that?
Yep.
Oh, then I might
Steam actually added some features. I mean, you also might have to download a minor program to
I have. I have Republic Commandos on here. I bought that over the winter sale.
I played a lot for
it's really fun.
For
it's
really
good.
Good.
I beat it.
Macros in the for a while. Then they can fix it. So, hey,
sweet. So, back to Star Wars, please. Back to the movie, excuse me. Because we've been talking about Star Wars, but, you know.
So, real quick, the one thing I did not like about Poe, out of the whole entire thing, like, I understand him as a character, and I understand this part as a, like, as a writer and stuff, but the deus ex machina of the thing. No, that's actually
a
term, though.
He was the deus ex machina character.
Yeah.
He was.
The fact that he literally is like,
explain that for the idiots, please.
Okay, so deus ex machina is actually comes from, like, is actually a Greek term that's usually used within theater. It's where you actually have a character who basically, in the sense, is going through a trial or something that's very discreet, like he's going to, say, die. All of a sudden, someone has a deus ex machina moment and saves him from the death.
It's essentially a deus ex machina, the scene that has, like, pretty much no bearing. It's just a random thing, a random event, a random character that appears to save the day or change the plot. It had no bearing whatsoever or anything else. It's just like...
But he, like, early in the movie, he's, like, pop dead. So we're like, oh, okay, so he's gone. He's never going to come back. The next thing we know, he's back here again because we know we have to have this ultimate X-Wing fighter pilot who's the best pilot in the squadron.
Finn's not
going to
do that.
It isn't quite a big alligator moment, but it's close. A big alligator moment is a scene that is there for no reason whatsoever, and they don't mention it ever again in anything.
Mm-hmm.
And just... It's like, because the term comes from a cinema critic view of Nim, Rathenim, where there's a scene where the big with alligator just singing, and there's no point to the song, no point to the character, just there, like, why was he there? There's no point to that. And they never speak of it again. So it's the ultimate point of this scene. So that's a bit of another word. But basically, also, there's a point that's kind of still kind of random.
Okay.
Can you point to it? It's still kind of random, like, oh,
yeah,
very much a character. Because he came in the beginning.
He comes to introduce
BBA.
So let's talk about Finn for a second.
And then he comes back, and you're like, well, you're back for 2 seconds. You died. Or you didn't even die. You, like, flew in, dropped some off, and came back.
So let's talk about Finn for a second.
Finn.
Really, really like Finn.
I
like the idea of a stormtrooper who doesn't necessarily agree with what he's being forced to do.
Yeah, that was pretty cool.
Because, you know, so far we've just been introduced to, like, what we thought were just stormtrooper volunteers.
Mm-hmm.
And the 501st Clone Legion. They're forced to do it. You know, they didn't have choice. They had the little organic shits in their brains.
Right.
They made them do it.
Yeah, the clone sort of troopers from...
And Aftermath actually talks about that. Part of the beginning of the book. Now, I know I'm the only one read it and stuff, or at least most of it here. But they were talking about, because it goes into, like, 4 different arcs. It's kind of gets annoying, but it's starting to get where I'm at right now, but they're starting to tie in together. But there was one part where they were actually talking about this this admiral trick who's actually controlling some sort of ship that's out covering the planet called Akira. Now, she was complaining about, like, how she doesn't have the best force or the actual best legion with her. Because all these people were the people who just were pulled out from the academy because at the moment of the destruction of the Death Star and the fall of the Emperor.
Mm-hmm.
Now, she has a whole bunch of people who are, like, half of them are actually the original bio-organics. But the other half are the people who were being trained by those bioorganics, because it's like she's trying to build up her force. So she has basically her most common legion that follows her along is the people with the highest scores and everything, but everybody else is guarding the ship, looking for, in this case, Wes, because he's actually survives and he's on the ship and actually does some random accident going, hey, we're going to blow up my ship right here and take out some of your guys, and I'm going to go sneaking in around through your ship, trying to get contact with the Republic, saying, hey, there's a couple of Star Destroyers over here. We don't know what they're doing, but I'm trying to get a signal out to you, but everything's jammed. But, yeah, the book actually did talk about how half the Stormtroopers are basically gone, like the actual Stormtroopers, like the biological Stormtroopers, and how some of them are actually people being trained from a young age, old. And that point was actually even brought up across within the movie.
Yeah, so now I'm under the impression the First Order, they're stealing babies and then making them Stormtroopers. That's what I was under the impression of, right?
So
was that the only thing I got that?
Yeah, I kind of got that. I kind of got, like, the almost, like, Spartan vibe with them.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's exactly what I thought.
But I don't want to trail into other...
I thought that up on the chat. I was like, so they're
Yeah. I remember that.
Spartans.
Yeah.
Like,
yeah.
Not really, but yeah, it's kind of a good thing.
Yeah.
It could never aim.
So we have DSS monster characters. Phasma.
No. Right, we're gonna talk about Phasma.
Okay.
This is the other character that I forgot that I don't like.
She does nothing.
Why did you even tease her?
Again, is this she's supposed to be more of a character in the like full first one or whatever it's called? The spinoff one.
Rogue One.
Rogue One.
Now that's when they're stealing the plans for the initial Death Star. That's what Rogue One's gonna be.
But I think she's supposed to be more bigger than that. And
well, how is she in Rogue One? You make no sense.
She's supposed to be a bigger character.
The Silver Stormtrooper.
Oh, the female Stormtrooper.
Captain Phasma's her.
Chrome Phasma.
She does nothing.
She's supposed to be a bigger part in some other spinoff thing.
Probably the next movie. I actually love the garbage chute part.
But she was.
You're just fishing. You're just fishing for nostalgia.
Yeah,
that's all they're doing.
But hey, it was actually interesting how they're like, hey, by the way, Han Solo was like, hey, we're in an Imperial place.
You know, I feel like they made Finn the meat guy
for that
joke and that joke alone.
Mm.
They were just fishing for nostalgia. That's
they were
all
doing
they were
that
doing.
A lot in the movie.
Yeah, they were. Because the first half is cool, interesting, and new.
Well,
and then the second half is just Death Star 2.0.
That's what I was saying. Like,
Death Star 2.0.
Yeah, no, I was legit just ripping you off. That's all it's doing.
Hey, at least you didn't do the same thing they did with the last Death Star, make a small port that you could just... Okay,
I mean, it did the same thing. They did the same thing, except this time
they made a gigantic complex out of it that connects all the way to the planet's core.
And you had to see for it.
Just
well,
so on.
Well, they see for it, but they didn't show it.
Yeah, right.
And then
yeah,
had,
see,
oh,
so
had
to go learn
we've naturally progressed to the topic of Han Solo's death.
Yes, we have.
So, fucking called it. Han Solo's a stupid motherfucker. Why the hell would you sit there and do that? The reason they did it is so that, what's his name?
Kylo
Ren?
The actor.
Oh, Harrison Ford.
Harrison Ford's contract was up. He didn't want to break his leg again, so they killed him off.
Yeah, I think he also pretty much wanted, or possibly wanted out of the series.
He wanted out since the first movie. He actually literally wanted to be out as of number 4. He did not want to be in Star Wars.
Oh, why not?
He just didn't. He did not like the character
at all.
Dude,
he's got so much fucking money.
Well,
yeah.
He
has
so much money from this shit. How much royalties do you think he gets paid every Blu-ray copy?
You know what's even more impressive? Harrison Ford started as Carpenter on, I think, the set of Indiana Jones. Was it Indiana Jones first?
No, there was a set. And he was starred in Indiana Jones.
Yeah, there was another. But he was a Carpenter on the set of Star Wars.
There was another movie I thought where he played.
I'm
not going to get into that because I wasn't alive.
It was.
But my information is totally wrong.
It was crazy.
Han Solo wants out. I love all the memes of, do anyone know Finn's actor's name?
I don't remember the actor's name on top of my head either.
But I love all the memes about him joking about being Han, or no, he's being pretty serious, about being Han Solo or Harrison Ford's best friend. In all the interviews that they've ever done, Finn's just like, yeah, Harrison Ford's my best friend. And he's doing that awkward, like Harrison Ford's just like, and Harrison Ford's just got that smile, that old Harrison Ford smile on. He's just sitting there dealing with like in his head, this is Finn's face, and Han Solo's just like, or Harrison Ford's just sitting there like talking about the movie.
We might have
this.
The same idea.
Yeah,
so there is a secret Rooster Teeth podcast where they had Harrison Ford on, but they didn't air it because Harrison Ford's an old curmudgeon. he's a very bitter person. And they just couldn't air it on their site.
Well, so sorry. There was an interview, I don't remember where it was at. Like,
the bomb balance.
Okay.
Hey.
What? I'm not attention to it.
Well,
what,
we're
going to hear it.
Audio's going to hear it.
I'm
going to
hear it.
Yeah,
it's just like, oh yeah.
Wow, we're
all there, by the way. But anyway, there was actually an interview with Harrison Ford when he's actually talking about promoting for like number 7. This guy actually had one of the original Lego sets for the Millennium Falcon built. And he actually, he worked at the studio that was interviewing on Harrison Ford. So he asked if Harrison Ford could sign the Millennium Falcon.
Did he break it?
He broke it. But he pulled it off like it was an accident. He was like, oh, okay, I guess I can sign it type thing. So as he's grabbing the Millennium Falcon, he actually trips in his own chair type thing.
But
why would he do that? Because he doesn't like the role, like I said. But it was funny because like, the guy's like sitting there going like, struck, because like, it obviously, I mean, yeah, obviously, Harrison Ford broke this little figure, this thing this guy had built and kept in mint condition.
For years.
But it was
years.
I mean.
How long has it been since 77?
I'm not sure if that's when this Lego set came out, though. I mean.
Okay. All right,
but,
so we'll give it 5 years.
Yeah.
Maybe two.
Yeah. I mean, I know when I had my set, I was like 7. So back
you,
in
you
like
guys, you guys know that I'm also part of the generation that saw the prequels first.
Yeah, I'm more.
I'm sorry.
But what he did at the end, he's like, okay, well, here, because he actually picked up a big chunk of your pie, and he signed it, and the guy's like, whatever, walks off, and Harrison Ford's like, okay.
Here's another Star Wars theater story. I don't remember how old I was, but Star Wars Episode 3 came out, and I went to go see it, and I was in small town Oregon at the time. I'm not going to say it because internet. I was in small town Oregon, in this, and we had to drive to a bigger town to a theater that had it. That's how, you know, that's how small town.
Right.
And we get there, and they everyone's in costume, and like some people are dressed as Darth Vader, and I'm sitting there like, I've never seen the originals. I didn't know who Darth Vader was.
Right.
So I go, Mommy, who's that? Why is he dressed like that? And he's like, that's the first time. I think I was old enough to like not cry about it.
Right.
But because Anakin was my favorite. I was a little kid, people, please have mercy in the comments. and that was the first time my parents knelt down beside me and told me, you know that Anakin Skywalker turned, I knew about Darth Vader, I had no idea what he looks like. You know that Anakin Skywalker turns into Darth Vader, right? I'm just like, what?
Well, you're about to find out. You still have to agree.
I was about to find out.
It's great. Wait, we gotta figure this out. How are we gonna tie in? 2 hours. Here to here.
So, no.
There's more measure because I would be like, well, you'll see here.
So, let me continue a little bit. So, we get into the movie, and the concessions people come into the theater, and they have a little concessions cart. Because they don't want anyone to have to miss the movie.
Right.
I thought that was cool. And they're like, yeah, so if anyone wants anything, just come down and talk to me and we'll get it. We only take cash because it is a car. Blah, 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 blah. Enjoy Star Wars. And it starts playing. And, you know. And then during the droid starship scene, when they're on Anakin's droid, some kid in front of us, someone about their like 3-year-old, starts crying.
Oh.
So I had to watch the entire beginning of Star Wars Episode 3 with a 3-year-old crying in front of me. I'm just sitting there like, and I know it's the funniest 30 minutes of that movie because the rest of it is just like, in your face, we're murdering children. You know, and so I had to watch the, you know, I had to watch the first 30 minutes that is supposed to prepare you for the heart-crushing, soulless bullshit that's to come with a crying 3-year-old in front of me.
Yeah.
So the funny R2 bits, what? Just the entire time I couldn't even hear R2 do his little beep boop beep. I couldn't hear it.
Did you know that technically R2-D2 is the only character who cusses the most in any movie?
Yes.
At all?
Because C-3PO constantly tells him to shut the fuck up.
Well, not that, but every single word that R2 says is a curse word because he gets beeped.
Oh, I hate you. I hate you. Micah?
That's it. I'm
gonna break the window.
I'm not doing the one clap. I'm gonna get that like an open hand.
What sound does the tree make when falling for us?
I don't know. What does it make?
No sound.
Because nobody's here to hear it.
Yeah.
Well, yeah.
You're a tree that fell in the forest. And
like,
that was a little far to go for a joke, but I did it.
I was in school and I was like, we were talking about that and like, or I was in biology. It was in.
I wear contacts.
Western,
that's why.
Or Eastern history or whatever. It was like.
Oh yeah.
Anyway, but because we learned about Buddhism and stuff like that, and we were like, and how. From a color and stuff that is all in your head.
Yeah, everyone perceives color is different. Blue is different to me than it does to you.
And technically speaking,
even though we still think it's the same.
Technically and scientifically speaking, if the tree falls in the forest and no one's going to hear it, literally doesn't make a sound because sound waves are just like, wait, air pressure, and we just have to put that sound. And so people in school, like, you know, tree falls in the forest and no one's going to hear it, then it actually doesn't make a sound. Like, yeah, it does. I'm like, no, it's just pressure waves. Like, well, what sound? Well, you sound pressure waves.
That's why there's no sound in space, you fucking curmudgeon.
Sound is just like our interpretation of pressure waves.
Yeah. So
real quick, just pull us back, because this actually does bring into a good topic. BB-8.
Yes.
And R2-D2.
Yes.
Like that combination right there. Like not to do anything weird, but like the actual persona of like how we're replacing R2-D2 with BB-8.
It's
like
basketball. Except for the alien didn't replace him.
We're replacing R2-D2 with a basketball.
I like
he's orange. Shut up.
I like Munich. But can we talk about how when Rey left, she took Chewie, which I guess when Pokemon shells R2-D2. Why didn't you take BB-8? I get that R2-D2 had the most complete
BB-8.
But
like, no one wants to carry around a soccer ball, Micah.
No one wants to have to put
a little
soccer ball in the middle of the space.
It was like, we're going to play BB-8 for one episode of this new trilogy, and that's it. And
well,
that's,
in this case, because BB-8 is more tied to Poe. Like, BB-8 is Poe's companion.
Yeah.
R2-D2 is more of Luke's companion, so it's made sense that...
R2-D2 is a little whore. He's everyone's companion.
He loves everybody.
Everybody
loves R2-D2, because R2-D2 is awesome.
Except for C-3PO.
Yeah.
Well, that's because R2-D2... R2-D2... R2-D2 could be a specious motherfucker. You don't know what he's saying. C-3PO could just translate the good bits.
You have no idea. I love how like, everyone has, like, fond memory of Star Wars, except for the actors who were there, and just, like, who we hate.
Well, you're going to keep doing it, because it's going to make $1 million.
I mean,
how much did it make opening week?
Oh my gosh, it actually sold out just internationally wise. Like, it actually was one in the top box office.
Oh yeah, it's also one of the only movies, one of the few movies to release everywhere at the same time.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I think
if they made people wait, there'd be riots.
And lots of torrents.
And lots of spoilers.
Which then brings up the fact that forever ago, before when it was just like teased with the first trailer for Force Awakens, how everyone was making this picture that had on the bottom Harrison Ford and Chewbacca, and it was just like, bitch, please, you were just the opening act.
Let's talk
about Han Solo death scene one more time in a little bit more detail. So Han Solo, they're on the cavernous pit. And Han Solo sees Kylo Ren. Instead of walking along like he should have, he goes, Ben! But it's kind of sweet that he named his son after Obi-Wan Kenobi.
Also kind of sweet, Han Solo.
Also, the reason I call him the reason I call him Obi-Wan Kenobi is because, again, saw the prequel first.
Yeah.
That's just, in my brain, that's who he is. so that's kind of sweet, nice and everything. But then Kylo Ren walks up to him. And Han, they're having their dad moment, and the entire time, my entire family in the first row, it's like, he's gonna get fucking shot. No, that's how my family talks to each other, by the way. We don't edit expletives. That's why I'm so bad. So he's gonna get fucking dead, he's gonna get fucking die, he's going for him to get shot. Yep, there is everyone in the theater is like we have four seats. We have four seats in the very front. And my entire family's just like, couldn't have done that better.
Yeah.
We
didn't
see it.
When me and Tim saw it, we were just like sitting there kind of going, yep, we see this coming.
We saw it coming. I was like, no.
We all saw it coming. And yet I still heard gasps. Right behind us.
It still hurts. That was the issue, though.
I didn't hear any gasps whatsoever. I got this all too late, and everyone was like, yeah.
I was not hurt by that fact.
I saw it Christmas Eve.
Because it was,
so there was a lot of families.
Because it was just like, Dad, I need your help. Are you willing to do anything that I ask you? And he's like, yes. And it was just like,
and then she was like, no.
And then
but it also seemed like Chewie didn't have the heart to shoot him.
He did shoot.
Oh, you're right. I'm sorry. No, you're right. I'm sorry.
For all the times that Chewbacca...
Everyone on the internet hate me. I saw it on Christmas Eve. I only saw it once.
So I want to point out that one, that stupid crossbow thing was demonstrated that really powerful and only put the pick in Ben. Because
fuck you. Because Han Solo liked it, that's
why. Han Solo did like it because he's just like, man, because
it's a charge shot. That's what put it on.
Yeah.
It was a quick shot. Chewie did a quick shot instead of a charge shot. If it was a charge shot, Ben would probably be knocked off.
Yeah, so I had this argument with a friend of mine. She just saw it like last weekend. And she's like, I loved the last scene when Rey kicked ass. I'm like, you realize the only reason she was winning was because he was hurt. She's like, yeah, my brother said the same thing, but I don't buy it. And then I went into explain this whole thing. Because she thought the Force was like, well, she had this impression. She hasn't watched most of the Star Wars. She watched them all once, like a long time ago, and then went to go see Episode 7. And so I had to explain the Force to her. And she's like, but the Force would totally make her be a bad. I'm like, no, it's not the Avatar state, okay?
It's not the Avatar.
I didn't say that, but I just thought that. God, look how funny I am, Internet. I had to explain to her, it's kind of like Spider-Man's Sixth Sense, except way better. And you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Because like, all it helps them do is like finally finesse everything, all their moves, because of the way that the Force makes them perceive their surroundings and their body and stuff like that. Yeah, right? Like not being stupid.
It does help.
Okay, but it also it gives them their sixth sense. That's why they can go block the bullet from behind them, right? So that's what they can move style. And I know it surrounds us and penders and all that shit. I know that. I'm not an idiot.
So
I explained that to her. She's like, well, I thought that would like make her fight. I'm like, no, you realize he has like 10 years of saber experience. And the only reason he fucking lost was because A, the ground was falling around him. B, he's been hurting himself the entire movie with his stupid little bitchy temper tantrum, and he just got shot.
And yeah. C, he got shot, and then he was just like, to show off how much of a badass he could potentially be, was just like, I'm going to punch myself.
He gets super angry and bring the dark side of Force even better.
It still makes it funny that with him weakened, Finn can actually go on par with him.
So now there's another theory that, like, that there aren't like people that... There are people that aren't necessarily Jedis, but are Force sensitive.
Mm.
I like that. I don't know if that's confirmed. I like that idea.
Can we just talk about how I was right about the stupid like lightsaber belt thing?
Oh my
bullshit.
God.
Yeah. But you know, it's really not a key for a hell because they're still lightsaber. So if you like, you know, because the point of the card is to pit yourself and cut yourself. If now if like blaze, you're still going to cut yourself, aren't you? And so
did
she had his arms. Like,
have you seen the How It Should Have Ended trailer?
Also,
talk about that.
Also, by the way, let's talk about how the vents for the block guard were still exposed and could potentially be cut off by the saber anyway.
Yeah, and the fact that they are still, and but the fact that
saber guard is like NASA already.
That his freaking lightsaber was also pretty much seemed like it was going through like a critical power surge every time he had it activated.
Yeah.
It had a weird noise to it, yeah. It had a different noise to it.
It
kind of looked like plasma.
Yeah.
You know, moving around like that.
Technically, it was supposed to be plasma.
Well, what he... Okay.
Yeah.
I see that facial expression.
It
you say what you want to say. You had it the same when I was trying to explain the Force, too. So you speak up.
Okay, so what's that lightsaber? I can't stand it. Like, the whole entire thing. Like,
right.
I mean, I get it. We got into the
Tim's angry.
This part. Ah,
So the openly angry one went first. Now it's the quiet angry one's turn.
Okay. Actually, I was going through the toy section, just taking a look to see what that. And I was looking at their little. I grew up with the original Village lightsaber thing, like the original kits, where you can change your colors, or even do a dual wielding lightsaber, like the actual original one from the first movie, which I actually like that idea.
Yeah,
but,
which by the way, this trailer spoil because he didn't use it for the first half of the movie, and then at the end he's like, psh. It's like a Terminator 2 situation, okay? You could totally say that.
I will say that the scene when you're in the trailer movie, he feels his lightsaber was at the very end of the movie, but, like, it didn't really spoil anything.
Okay.
The whole show.
So, when I was looking through, I was looking at the new set they had for, like, your build your lightsaber set, and I was looking at it, and they had this, like a brass knuckle design, where it's like, you can actually have 5 lightsabers on it, and I was like, why?
What?
Why would you do that?
It was set up so you can actually have, like, the main hilt, the centerpiece, so you, like, you punch somebody, I guess. I don't know, and they had like
why
one.
Why would I want to do that?
I don't know. I was thinking this one, like, why would you do this?
I will say, though, I could totally see, like, the Wolverine claws. That'd be kind of cool, but that'd be
good. But no, but then that would have to be three straight. I'm talking, like down over vertical at the same time.
Yeah, that's kind of
stupid. I was like, why the. No, I don't know why I would do that in the first place. But coming into with that whole entire lightsaber thing, there's been discussion about did he cut his hand off or did Rey cut the hand off?
Whenever so, I thought Rey cut.
I was thinking this is the part where I get to call bullshit on my scene and I didn't see the hand get cut off.
That's the thing, though. It's a moment of disbelief. That's what I'm saying, though. From what I'm understanding, and it would make air quotes sense since you know they're constantly making references back to the original series, his hand would get cut off right there.
His hand would get cut off. I know that. I thought. Because, like, there's a scene where, like, something lands off to his side. I thought that was his head. Because, like, did she just cut off his head? And, like, oh, no, that was just his hand.
All right, we have...
I could come up with an argument based on...
Second time in the podcast we've lost video.
Is this, like, every 30 minutes?
I guess so.
Okay.
The last time I checked, the battery was almost dead, so I assume we shut this off because the battery was almost dead.
All right.
I apologize. I don't know how long this is.
It doesn't matter.
But, so yeah, that whole entire...
Yeah. With the hand thing. It's every
30 minutes Tesla
battery
right now.
Okay. Yeah. I can come up with an argument on why I think that it was a little bit of that she cut his hand off, but he kind of did it as well. He saw that he was kind of... He saw that he was losing... And saw that his hand was being a complete disadvantage to him at that moment, so he was just like, "Hey, you know what? Off with it."
Oh, he cut his own hand off?
Probably. I'm making the argument that she did cut it off, but he kind of let her do it because it was proving to be disadvantage.
Again, I'm going to call bullshit on my theater seating and my patience.
Well,
yeah.
Because they were like fighting for that.
And also her technique with. The quote-unquote lightsaber that was used to murder the little ones by Anakin Skywalker,
the child killer
lightsaber. She was not really like using it to its full extent.
She
was like a kid with a toy lightsaber.
Yeah, she was like a kid with a toy lightsaber, and she was like fencing. Lunging with most
well, yeah,
of her
but if you think
honey,
about
you're
her,
awesome.
Her main weapon the entire time that she's had was you know, like a staff. So if you use even like a staff, it was kind of like fancy.
Yeah, yeah. Honey, you're not awesome.
You're not awesome.
See, I said that before, but no one laughed. So I didn't know if you hear me or you're just trying to ignore me. Tim was trying to ignore me because I never heard it.
Which is why she went all this.
I'm going to see that in the podcast.
Also, was that the original plan to get her? The original plan wasn't to get her to Luke. That was like after they discovered Rey, like, hey, hey, you could go meet Luke. So,
the
original plan was to find him and bring him back.
Yeah, I thought that it ended right after they got the final piece of the map. And then it's like, he's right there. We shall find him.
Yeah, I wanted it to end there too.
Hey, guys. I'm not very good on the meaning of Deus Ex Machina, but you want to talk about another Deus Ex Machina character? May or may not be OGD2.
That was Deus Ex Machina moment too.
Aha! I was correct in my understanding.
Yeah, because he was like,
I'm just dead the whole movie. Okay.
He was there for the map, and then, now you can go with her, too.
Hey, I'm just a dead husk. Oh, you mean
you need
I'm sorry, what? Huh? I'm alive.
Okay,
what?
But their term for why he had to come back, he was searching his database to find the map.
No, fuck that.
Okay, I'm sorry.
R2-D2
managed to hack a whole entire database on a Death Star and find all the
Didn't he bring down a whole Star Destroyer in fucking Clone Wars one time?
Yeah, I know.
He hacked an entire, like, Separatist base and fucked it up and made it blow itself up in one of the episodes. So, like, you're telling me he takes, like, 200 years to find...
To look
10 years?
No, 10 years
to find stupid map?
Yeah.
He needs that much processing power that he has to shut everything down? Fuck off. The dude can motherfucking fly and hack at the same time. Who gives a shit?
Disney.
And look, we don't talk about the devil mouse.
It's demonic.
This is the same thing.
They did go a little overboard with the advertisement for Star Wars. I will admit that.
Yo, I got that BB-8 orange back in my house.
But
do you guys have that Star Wars?
Fuck no.
I want that Star Wars.
No, the BB-8 oranges.
But
Star Wars makeup. Why do you want your lips to look lightsaber blue?
But I won't.
And he has to.
I mean, Disney does it with all licenses. I mean, look at Marvel. They really sucked up their outfits.
Is there Marvel makeup?
Probably. Like Silver Iron Man or something like that, you know?
Silver? You mean War Machine?
No, because the original Iron Man suit was actually silver.
Well, it's
just
red and gold.
They're probably called War Machine, let's be honest.
That's more like charcoal black.
He wants to be a
stat. Also, I want to say that the Deadpool movie might actually be better than any other Marvel movie out.
But is Deadpool technically Marvel? Because I thought it was done by Fox.
It is done by Fox. But it's still technically MCU. It's still Marvel.
Yeah, we're all seeing that, right?
Yes.
I love... Okay, sidetrack. Real quick.
We can be done with Star Wars at any time.
Okay, real quick, I mean, let's for the sake of this podcast, because we are kind of over our actual idea of a limit.
I'd say
on a scale of 1 to 10, personally, what do you guys think?
1, 20, 1, 30, we can get it somewhere in that range, so we can when we are on tangents, that's the extent of the detail.
So for me, I liked the movie. I thought it was all right. It wasn't the greatest movie ever. Like I've said, there's a reason why it didn't make anybody's movie of the year.
Mm-hmm. Or like IMAX.
Yeah.
I always thought it was like a quarter dispute. If it came out in this quarter, it can't be fair. It's thought of.
Well, even then, Oscars. It got nominated for Oscars, which is not for movie of the year. It got like best score and stuff like that.
Best score.
But it did not get nominated for movie of the year. Like, there's a reason for that, because there's too much, in my opinion, there's way too much nostalgia.
Mm-hmm.
They were nostalgia fishing.
Yeah, and I was like, but my opinion is, it was good enough, I liked it good enough, and without...
You know, we're probably one of the, like, 20% of the people on the internet that have that opinion.
Yeah.
Every other podcast or thing I've seen is like, yes, the movie's amazing, we can't stop kissing his ass, except kicking.
But now that we don't love it,
we're okay with it.
Now that we're done with all the television, now the 7, 8, and 9 can be their own stuff, and you know, on their own story.
Unless they do some minor nostalgia fishing.
Well, they're probably doing minor nostalgia fishing with Luke, but there's probably one.
Can I say that I haven't seen Mark Hamill since episode 6?
Yeah.
I've only heard his voice because he's a Joker.
Right.
That man is aged well.
Okay.
I got another film for you later. We'll talk about it later.
Can I say that the scene at the very end where she's just like...
He was there for 1 second.
You just like sitting like...
Wait, was he doing that?
The camera was literally spinning around the...
Oh, that's right.
He's just like holding the lightsaber out. Are you going to do anything with the lightsaber or are you just going to hold it?
She's
waiting for Luke to
break into her eyes. They just stare like directly into each other's eyes and be like,
We paid money for that fucking helicopter to spin around this island, goddammit, and we're gonna get as much spinning as we want. We're gonna get as much goddamn spinning as fucking J.J. Abrams wants. He paid for that goddamn helicopter, and we're gonna get a fucking money's worth.
Probably his own private helicopter. Yeah, okay. People do that. He's not as stupid as
too much money for fuel.
Did you know that most of the cars of the Econsys that we make were Nicholas's stage cars?
No.
They're like all three of his personal collection.
Wait, which one series?
Gone 60 Seconds.
Oh, okay.
The remake when he was in. Yeah, they used pretty much a good chunk of his weapon.
Perfect. So we keep on track. So on a 1 in 10, what would you give it?
Fuck, you want that?
1 in 10. I'd probably give it about a 7.
Okay.
Oh, that's generous.
That is being generous.
That's generous.
I would give that about an 8 or 9.
Yeah, I'm down for that. I agree with that. Casey.
Scale of 1 to 10. 5.
Just smack dead middle.
It was not very good, but it wasn't very bad. It was kind of in the middle of at okay to meh.
6.5.
Damn, that's a 10 to...
It gets the extra point. It gets the extra 1.5 for not being the prequels.
All right, so for me, for the movie, overall... As a standalone, like if it was my first time ever watching it, like getting into the series, I think it would actually have been better. But the fact is, since I've known a lot of the original six movies, because I understand like games, books, everything prior to it, other than like the prelude to A Force Awakens things, are basically not even in there anymore. First half was unique, and that's actually the reason why I would actually give it like a 7. So I actually love the first half of the film.
Okay, you want to rate it on halves?
No.
Okay, you give your overall, and then I want to hear you rate the halves. All right, that's what I want.
You want the overall?
I want the overall first, and then rate the halves. That's what I want.
Okay. Overall would actually be like between a 6 and 7, so I guess in this case it's 6.5.
Okay, yeah. No. This is not the prequels.
For this case, for your half situation, for the first half, which I felt was really unique, it actually helped build characters and help establish who was who and what's going on, I would definitely give that more like an 8, because it actually kept me focused on it. After that point, I felt disconnected from the movie. Like I can,
because I started nostalgia fishing as soon as Han Solo and Chewbacca.
They started nostalgia fishing way before that. I mean,
did that?
Oh,
wasn't
yeah.
Ray and Luke are and Kylo and Vader are. Yeah.
But for the second half of it, because I felt like they were just literally rehashing 4.
Yeah.
So that's literally what I felt like with watching the actual second half. Like, I mean, up to the point. Honestly, when I got disconnected was actually after Han was taking Rey and Finn and BB-8 to the
new cantina.
That new cantina and stuff to go start working. At that point, I kind of felt...
When did they say Snoke's name?
Like, right before that, I believe?
That's when I lost interest.
Okay, so... For that part itself, I would actually more give it, like, maybe a 4, in all honesty, because it... There's good enough action and there's good enough plot for me to actually enjoy it.
Real quick, I want to talk about the cinematics of the aerial and fight scenes on the Cantina planet, whatever that planet was.
Mm-hmm.
The Endor remake, whatever that was.
Yeah.
Yeah. So they did a really good job of like being Star Wars Battlefront 3.
Yeah.
You know what I mean by that?
Yeah.
Going from space battle to ground battle really quickly.
And
that's what I thought of when I was watching it. Like, well, that's...
So, I'm gonna first, I get, that would justify my 7. 7 for Finn.
Yeah,
Finn was a good enough character. A unique little character. Because he did his house vision with everyone except for Finn. Mm-hmm. And he was like, good Finn.
Yeah, he was really cool. Like that, Finn made the movie for me.
Yeah.
He was really cool. Finn's a good character.
And I will say the scene with her flying around Jakku in the Millennium Falcon and all her acrobatics, that was badass. I don't know what Emo says, that was like the coolest fight scene.
And how did that happen again?
You got hit.
Yeah.
Oh, okay, got hit. Again, only seen it once, saw it on December 24th, and I was like this the entire movie, so leave me alone.
And I'm going, well, if that gun stuck, why not move to the other one?
Yeah, there's one on the bottom, jackass.
Well,
they just gave me an excuse to show off how badass of a pilot she was without any proper training.
Yeah, that's the thing. She didn't have any proper training. So I also look a bullshit on that scene, but I still love that scene.
All right, everyone. And then this news. No, Casey, we're done now.
Okay, okay.
We're done now. Casey, you shut the fuck up. So, this has been the whatever the fuck we call this podcast. Don't remember.
Game Over Podcast.
Game Over. See, I said it. Don't remember. This is, I'm Evan, C052, and enjoy this bullshit for like the next 2 years or so until I stop hanging out with these idiots.
So I'm Tim Orkino. You guys take care.
I'm Sean Ormega. Whatever you want.
I'm Casey, or you can just call me.
Casey.
I'm Steve.
Whoops.
And we will see you next time.
Have fun.